No, she can go live on hers too.
I don't know.
No, I'm saying she can go live on hers. I'll just log into hers. Yeah.
I didn't know that.
All right, we're about to get started with some praise and worship. Thank y'all for tuning in.
Yeah. Hope you guys are having a wonderful week, those who are watching in.
It's too far back.
Sons and daughters, God, we're hired to the throne, and we come bold before the throne of grace to obtain mercy, Lord. Father God, where angels' feet are tread, God, you welcome your sons and daughters. The courts of heaven, the throne room of heaven is open every single time we cry out and say, Abba. So we say, Abba, tonight, Jesus, we exalt your name. Holy Spirit, we invite your presence. Would you sing through us? Would you pray through us? Holy angels, we invite you to come alongside and worship us with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Courts of heaven, we cheer us on as we pray tonight. Father, I thank you for those who are tuning in to watch us, those who tune in after. God, would you anoint this time, Father God, to do what you desire to do to your sons and daughters, to heal broken hearts, Father God, to draw sons and daughters back to you, Father God, for have faith arise, Lord God, in the midst of fire and trials, O Lord God, that they can testify that you are Lord, you are faithful, and that you are good. And that the weapons of our warfare, Father God, said are not carnal, but the mighty God from pulling down strongholds, Father God. And we know the weapon of choice, Father God, today, the weapon of choice forever is worship. Because when we worship in the midst of our enemies, when we worship in the midst of darkness, the demons have to flee. When we worship in the midst of our mess and our trials, Lord God, then we dance with the fire rather than having it burn us. God, we worship you. We let our hearts before you. We cleanse our hearts even as we come before you right now. Purify our hearts. And I pray you just take a moment right now to examine your heart. God, if there's anything in us that's not of you, God, to get out. Anything we did today, this week, gossiping, slandering, talking about somebody, lustful thoughts, sinful thoughts, Lord God, being disobedient, ungrateful, complaining, murmuring, Father God, judging, being critical, God, forgive me. Forgive us, Lord. And purify us, Lord God. We come in your presence to be refreshed, and more importantly, to pour out our love and worship at your feet, Lord. We are so deserving of it right now, Lord God. And the time right now and the time in our world are now so dark. People are rejecting you, blaspheming you. Jesus, we come before you as your bride to lavish love upon our King, who's Lord of our lives. We love you, Lord. We glorify you. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen. Amen. Amen.
In Exodus 30, verse 6, it says, God is speaking of the position of the Ark of the Covenant. He says, place the incense altar just outside the inner curtain that shields the Ark of the Covenant. In front of the Ark of the Covenant, the place of atonement that covers the tables, tablets, inscribed with the term of the terms on the covenant, I will meet with you there. So it said the covers that covers the tablets inscribed with the terms of the covenant, saying, I will meet you there. God showed me that last night. He put the incense outside of the curtains that covered the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant had the Ten Commandments in it. So he said, at the place of the incense, before before the veil, or after the veil, is where he will meet you. Where he will meet you is when we come into a place of worship and we give him a sweet smell. When we give him a sweet smell, when we sacrifice to him. When we sacrifice our hearts to him, he says he will meet us there. So I just encourage you to worship. Just to give him your heart. And let it burn. Let it burn. Let it burn. Because when it burns inside of you, when your heart is actually open to him, he smells and he's filled with joy. And he meets you right where you are. He meets you right where you are.
Church, your brides, your family seek you, God, not for miracles, not for blessings, God, not for what you can do, but just for your face. To be with you, Lord. You are my husband. You are my everything.
us like, Lord. We just bless your name, God, because your word says that you will never leave us nor forsake us, God. And we know that we are not alone.
Yes.
So we declare on tonight, God, that we are not alone, Heavenly Father, that you are with us, that you are walking right beside us, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Jesus.
Those who live in the shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty.
Or trials or tribulations. We don't understand why the Lord allows us to suffer at times, but we have to understand he puts us in the worst situation to bring out the best in us. So through the trials and tribulation, a lot of times he burns things in us that are not of him. And he really begins to test and shake our love. A lot of times, many of us, he spoke to me this week, you know, like, Nani, you confess me with your mouth, but your heart is far from me. And that shook me to the core. I'm like, Lord, really, me, Lord? And I really had to examine my heart to really think about it and see all that I was going through, that, yeah, I'll confess what I believe by faith and declare, but truly my heart was far. My heart was so consumed with what was going on with my circumstance. My heart was so consumed with things of this world rather than fixed on him. And how many of us are like that? So I just want to say right now, encourage you, if you're right now in the tribulation, if you're in a trial, know that God is lying to carry that cross. Oh, yeah. God's lying to carry that cross for a reason. He allows sufferings upon us. And a lot of times we have the sufferings upon us. We're actually carrying a cross for him. We're carrying a cross for another soul that's in desperate need right now. So when you really begin to think of the trials and tribulations, offer back up to the Lord. And in worship and adoration and praise to the Lord, knowing that he doesn't waste absolutely nothing. That even when the enemy intends for evil, he turns around for good.
Be on my list, your praise will
looks like, Lord God. You are not man that you should lie. Your promises are true.
Never be on my lips, your praise will never be on my lips. Never be on my lips, your praise will never be on my lips. Never be on my
lips. Thank you, Jesus.
ask of me for living water, and I will give to you. That's what Jesus said to the woman at the well. If you only knew who I was, you would ask of me, and I will give you living water. Living water. Living water. Father, we know you. We know you. We ask, Lord, that you pour out your living water on date night with Jesus. Pour out your living water on the souls of your people. Pour out your living water from today, yesterday, and on, Lord Jesus Christ. All of the days we walk on this earth, let our lives be a kiss from heaven that pours out living water. Let it be like a stream flowing from the heavens through us, to us, and onto your children. With the voices that you have given us, Father, I pray that you impart your living water in our vocals, in our guitar, in our instruments, in our prayer and prayer language, Lord, in our hums and oohs, Lord Jesus. Let there be living water in Jesus' name.
We're able to do above and exceed above our faith. That's the type of God that we serve. Let's pray. Or demons have come to dwell there and stay there and believe that lie is the truth. So as we're declaring this, think about the lies that the enemy has been telling, the suggestions over and over again. And get to declare God's word. For the word of God says he gives us all authority. Whatever we bound on earth, we bound in heaven.
Yes.
So we command those strongholds to come down in the name of Jesus. Every vain thought, high imagination, every lofty thing that's exalted itself up against the knowledge of God, be cast down, and we hold our thoughts captive to obedience of Jesus Christ. We declare that again. Declare that with us. We are victorious.
Yeah.
Every high thing must come down. Every stronghold shall be broken. You wear the victor's crown. You overcome. You overcome. Every high thing must come down. Every stronghold shall be broken. You wear the victor's crown. You overcome. You overcome. Every high thing must come down.
Thank y'all for tuning in.